Good day, guys. Austin here, and in this one today, we are taking a close look at 3DS games playing on our Android devices. Now, I released a video a few days back covering Citra now running on Android. That is absolutely groundbreaking and something that I didn't expect at the time. All the news was brand new, it was new to me, and I was pretty much playing catch up on that day to try and find as much information to give to you as possible straight from the horse's mouth. Now, there are lots of myths, there's lots of videos, there's lots of misinformation that is gathering around the internet right now as people get on this hype train. Now, it is great and it is awesome. It is completely legitimate, it is open there, and people can in fact do this. But again, there is so much misinformation and people just casting rumors and all kinds of stuff. What I want to do in this video is bring you up to date with some of the enhancements that are coming through with Citra, some of the feedback that you guys have been given, and answering many of the questions that you guys have been asking. Now, if you haven't seen my previous video, I will implore you to do so. It does cover a lot of the stuff which I'm not going to cover in this video, but what I want to do is bring you completely up to date is where we're at right now and some of the exciting stuff which is happening right in the future. So without further ado, let's get stuck in. So first off, I want to concentrate on an update to you guys to give you up-to-date information as to what the hell has been going on, where we're at right now, and what to expect in the near future. But first off, let's take you back. So, the Citra team seen what was going on YouTube. There's a huge buzz. The world has erupted in uproar as people can now play 3DS titles on the Android phone. It is completely legitimate. It's not a scam. There's no weird stuff going on. It's all above board. It's all completely legal. And you can now 100% play 3DS on your Android. But there is lots of caveats to go along with that. So the Citra team seen what was going on. And it was released, as we talked about in the previous video, Sin Chin Vin. Now, as part of the fork, they contacted him and they are more than happy to say that he is joining the core Citra team. They will be working towards an official polished Citra port to Android in the near future. The current app or APK is working off an old build of Citra. It still needs lots of tinkering to get it up to its full functionality. So think of that build as more of a teaser as to what is about to be unleashed. More of a demo, let's say. So with all this in mind, I can tell you now that the cat is well and truly out of the bag. Everybody knows that Citra or 3DS games can be played on Android devices and it is very fruitful. The future is very bright. In fact, the Citra team have known about this for some time because secretly, they've been working on it themselves for some time. Now, this isn't a story of they did it first and yeah, we've been working on this for ages. It has actually been out there to the general public for ages. It's just that nobody's actually picked up on it and, well, it's only Sin Chin Vin doing the hard work himself, which is actually proven to everybody else other than the Citra team that this is now actually something that can happen. Now that the Citra team has seen it public, it's now made sure that this will come to fruition even faster. Now, if you was to go onto the Citra team and their developers' GitHubs, their repositories, and all that kind of stuff, you'll actually see code working along these lines for a long time. They have denied that it has been working and that they are working on it and all that kind of stuff, not to keep it under wraps, not to keep this secret like some, I don't know, underground emulator that only special people can use, but because they didn't want to give people false hope at this stage. They know that this journey will be a long one. It's a lot to port such a high-end handheld device over to an Android phone. Even if you have got the latest one out there, it does take a hell of a lot of resources, which, to be honest, hasn't really been seen in the emulation scene up to now. Now, with Sin Chin Vin and his breakthroughs that he implemented all on his own into the official Citra builds, and then having the official Citra themselves working together, now means that they can push forward the development of this even faster. They did have this on the sideline. This was being a work in progress for a long time. Development wasn't really pushing forward because they were concentrating more on the PC side of things. Now that this has blown up all over the internet and they've seen the kind of feedback that people are getting and the hunger that they have for playing this on the mobile phones, they have now sped up that development cycle, and so we can see this even faster. It means that straight from the horse's mouth, this will probably be available within the next month or two. The first release of this will be groundbreaking, a lot better than what you've just seen on the previous build. That demo build was working on an older version of Citra. A lot of the enhancements, compatibility and performance tweaks that are in the more later builds of Citra haven't been implemented into that one. Firstly then, let's take a look at the compatibility. One of the biggest features that one of the new builds will bring along is what we call, who've been doing this on the PC for a while, the user folder. Now, in older versions of Citra, you needed what was known as the user folder to play some games. What this is basically your profile from your 3DS imported into the emulator. Now, they can't put this in as standard because a lot of the assets that are in that user folder are actually protected or under copyright from Nintendo. So some of the fonts, some of the assets that are used in order to make the games run are actually included in there. And because they are property of Nintendo, they can't include it because, like I said, this is a completely legal emulator. So sharing anything that's owned by anybody else isn't right. But they do show you on the website how to sort all that kind of stuff out yourself if that's the way you want to go. But with the more recent builds, they've actually got around this by using or trading off some of the more open source assets, such as license free fonts and all that kind of stuff, implemented into that user folder. So yep, it's not 100% from the original Nintendo 3DS, but it is fully compatible, and unless you were looking really, really closely, you would never ever notice. So that wasn't included in the original one, so when you went to load up some of the games, they would just crash because it was looking for that user folder, for those fonts, for those assets, which meant that when it couldn't find it, the game just stopped. And that meant that many of the games that are playable on Citra weren't playable in that version. Another issue, and probably the biggest one, which you'll notice when you're launching and you do get the games to work, is the actual speed in which they run at. So the original 3DS run anywhere between 20 to 60 frames per second, with depending on what game you're running. Now, with the way that this game is being emulated, you're probably getting about 50% of that at best, even on the highest end mobile phones. Now, this is mostly down to the bottleneck of the CPU. It's got nothing to do with the graphics drivers or what rendering processes it uses. It's all being bottlenecked at this moment by the CPU. Now, on the PC, we had the exact same problem. It was to do with the CPU JIT. That is what they come up with as a solution to solve this problem. And the problem is that that hasn't yet been implemented over to the Android version of this port. But good news is that it does know about, people are working on it, and this is the biggest reason why this build wasn't released to the public by the Citra team themselves. They wanted to get this worked on, solved and pushed out, so it's ready to go straight out the box. Now, as of yet, we're not using CPU JIT. It's running completely without. And with that, what's basically happening is it's, as you play through the game, it's taking the code or the game information, it's reading it, it's processing it, it's pushing it out, reading it, processing, pushing it out, reading, process, push it out. That's happening over and over again, countless times per second. And with that comes processor power, and much of that information doesn't actually need to be used because it's either already done it or it's just useless information that doesn't need to be processed in the first place. Now, what CPU JIT was, it actually learns that process. So if it doesn't need to do it, it doesn't do it. And if it has done it already, it just pushes it out, so it doesn't need to process it every time. Which means that, yeah, from time to time, you may get a little stutter here and there as it does something new, but in most cases you'll find that it just runs over and over again and you won't even notice it. It runs games full speed due to the implementation of this. Now, like I said, in this build, it's not implemented. It hasn't been able to be translated into the Android version, and that is what they've been working on. For example, if I was to load up my version of the PC one, as you can see now, you'll see at the top here, we've got emulation tab, configure. And if you was to go over to the debug tab, and you'll see under miscellaneous, we've got enable CPU JIT. A standard, this will come ticked, and there's no reason to untick this at all. It won't help, won't do anything other than actually slow your game down. This is one of the biggest breakthroughs that came through when they first started making the actual Citra emulator on the PC. So if I was to disable this right now, I'm running this on an 8700K, an i7, overclocked to 5GHz. My PC can run this pretty well, even with this disabled, but let's see how well it does run. So I'm gonna load up Super Mario 3D Land, and as you can see, at the bottom of the screen, we are currently running 85%, so running around 50 frames per second. This is a 60 frame per second game, so that is on an 8700K overclocked to 5GHz. If you were to translate that onto even the fastest mobile phone processor, the knock on performance would be times, I can't even do Carol Vorderman maths, but you get my point. This system can't run this without CPU JIT. If you were to run it on a mobile phone, the hit would be astronomical, as you are seeing while playing it on that build. So the sooner they get their CPU JIT sorted, the sooner you will see the kind of performance that you want. Now, as of yet, the build that they're going to release first likely won't include this kind of CPU JIT performance. They are working on this tirelessly, and they have been for some time. That's one of the biggest reasons why they never actually released this to the public yet. They wanted to get that right. Now, it will take some time. They are on about maybe even a year before we see this implemented to the kind of standard which we would expect. And even then, the phones may not be able to handle it. Yeah, they may be able to run it at full speed, but with the processing power that's enabled, even through the JIT, you may still see slowdown due to the throttling of the amount of information that is being processed through your CPU. Rest assured that it is being worked on and they do know about this. So the great thing is that this isn't something that they need to learn or something like that. It's actually something that they know about. It's just a case of actually building it to push it out so you guys can reap the rewards just like everybody else. So that is the biggest hindrance for now in terms of speed. When it comes to the sound, obviously through that emulator now, there is no sound whatsoever. And that's probably a good thing. You see, when you have low speeds on these games running through Citra, it's not very well optimized for sound, even on the PC version. So if you've got fluctuating frames per second and all that kind of stuff, you get a lot of crackling, you get a lot of warping, and it's just not a good experience all round. Once the speed is somewhere up to above par, then the sound probably will be enabled so you guys don't get deafened. So yeah, it's all there, it's all being worked on, and hopefully now this has brought and shined some light onto the reasons why we're not seeing the performance and the emulator working to its full potential. It's all known about, people know exactly what to do, it's just a case of making the magic happen. So to summarize all this then, it is being worked on. People know what the problems are and it is pushing forward as fast as people can handle. And Sin Chin Vin is now part of the Citra team. So it means that open source has triumphed again. Yep, he did make a fork, he did branch off from it, but he's been brought back into the fold. People are now working together and it's just blown this completely open. So people are striding forward. As you can see, people know all the problems. People can see what needs to be done. It's just a case of implementing it all so this magic can happen. Hopefully from me making this kind of video and you guys knowing about this, it could bring more public awareness. It could bring more people into the fold. developers out there who want to get involved, who think they could aid this kind of cause, go over to the Citra Discord, go over to the Citra website, ask about it, employ your help. They are greatly needed on it. If you are no good at that kind of stuff, try and contribute towards the Patreon. I'll put link in the description down below. Funds all go towards making this magic happen. It's completely voluntary in terms of you donating and, of course, the work that they do. All the funds go towards the development. It's not them sitting on a beach somewhere and living it up. These are all volunteers putting in their spare time to make this magic happen so you guys actually get a free emulator. Nothing of this will ever be paid. If you see scams on websites asking you to put in your details, asking you to pay for certain files, folders, and all that kind of stuff, do not do it. That is not what Citra is about, and it's not what this community is about over there. They are completely above board, completely doing this legitimately. They don't want to side on any dodgy dealings or anything like that. They just want to make you play your games as you had intended for the love of gaming in general. And I love that kind of stuff. So thank you so much to the Citra teams. Thank you so much for your help making this video, bringing this kind of public awareness to you guys. Look at their Twitter. I'll put links in the description down below for that also. On there, they are going to do a public statement reiterating a lot of the subjects that I've covered here, and well, you guys can get involved and talk to them also. I'll put links to everything that I've covered in the description as always. But thank you so much to my Patreons. It's you guys that make me tick over at the end of the day so I can make magic like this happen. I do want to bring updates for you guys so you can cover the development of Citra and, of course, all the different emulators out there. It's my Patreons that make this magic happen. Covering subjects like this, they just don't get money from YouTube. It's just not the way it works. It's not trendy, so I don't get the views that I possibly could do if I covered more drama-related topics. But I've got to thank each and every one of you, and even if you don't have the funds to support me or anything like that, it's not expected. Even just a like, a comment, a share, anything that you can do to help these kind of videos and bring awareness to this kind of stuff happening in the scene is greatly appreciated. So thank you very much for joining me today, guys. Links to everything in the description. Please like, please share, please do all the magical things in this wonderful world where we finally get 3DS games working on our mobile phones. What a glorious day. But most of all, you guys have a good day. Laters!